The Philippines also joining Japan in mourning the death of their former prime minister. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. called Abe Shinzo a devoted friend and supporter of the Philippines. Marcos noted Abe's contribution to Japan-Philippine ties will be written as one of the most exceptional periods in the bilateral history of the two nations. Former President Rodrigo Duterte also paying tribute to his dear friend, sharing on Facebook that Abe was not just the first foreign leader to visit the country after his election, but also the only foreign leader to visit his home in Davao City. His daughter, Vice President Sara Duterte, meanwhile, called Abe's death a shocking tragedy that exposed the dark side of humanity. She said the world lost a great leader. World leaders paying tribute to slain Japanese Prime Minister Abe Shinzo. U.S. President Joe Biden called his death a tragedy for Japan and for all who knew him. He added, Abe's vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific will endure. For British Prime Minister Boris Johnson, Abe's global leadership will be remembered by many. He added, the UK stands with Japan during its dark and sad time. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau also paying tribute to Abe, saying, the world has lost a great man of vision. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, meanwhile, described Abe as a towering global statesman and an outstanding leader who dedicated his life to make Japan and the world a better place. United Nations Chief Antonio Guterres also expressing grief. He says he will always remember Abe's collegiality and commitment to multilateralism. The shooter of former Japanese Prime Minister Abe Shinzo admits to his crime. Police said the gunman, identified as 41-year-old Tetsuya Yamagami, had used a homemade gun. He bore a grudge against an organization he thought Abe was linked to. Abe died in the hospital Friday, hours after being shot during a campaign activity in the city of Nara. His death rattled the country with one of the world's lowest rates of gun violence. Shootings are extremely rare in Japan. With strict firearms laws, buying guns in Japan require a long and complicated process. Now, U.S. President Joe Biden signs an executive order aimed at protecting abortion rights. This is in response to the landmark decision by the Supreme Court overturning the Roe v. Wade ruling. Biden says the order will safeguard access to abortion care and establish an interagency task force to use every federal tool available to protect that access.
I'm signing this important executive order. I'm asking the Justice Department that, much like they did in the civil rights era, to do something, do everything in their power to protect these women seeking to invoke their rights. In states where clinics are still open, to protect them from intimidation, to protect the right of women to travel from state that prohibits seeking the medical attention that she needs to a state to provide that care.
An epic court battle awaits billionaire Elon Musk after he announced he is ditching his $44 billion deal to buy Twitter. Twitter board chairman Brett Taylor vowed to sue to hold Musk to the terms of the buyout deal, saying he is confident they will prevail. On Friday, Musk pulled the plug on the deal through a letter to Twitter's top lawyer. There he said the social media giant is in a, quote, material breach of multiple provisions of the original agreement. For weeks now, Musk has expressed concerns about the proliferation of bots and spam accounts on the platform. Analysts have speculated the Tesla CEO's concerns may be an attempt to create a pretext to get out of the deal that he now sees as overpriced.